Hello, my name is Doug Leisure, and I wanted to record this video to show you a demonstration of the software that I created for our church to help count and record the weekly donations. It worked so well for our church that a few years ago I started giving a copy of it for free to all of the churches that requested a copy. So far, I've given it to more than 750 churches, mostly in the U.S., but also some in other countries as well. So you probably recognize this as an Excel spreadsheet, and you would be correct. In fact, that's all you really need in order to use my software, is a copy of Excel on a Mac or a PC. Now, it contains hundreds of cell formulas, but you don't have to know how to create Excel formulas to use it. I've done all of that work for you. I've also protected my cell formulas so that you can't accidentally break them. The other thing I did was to color code the places where you need to do your entry to record your donations in the yellow cells. So let me show you how easy it is to do a donation recording, to record the donation for a weekly offering. So we start with a date of the offering, and then we just enter the donor numbers, the amounts that they gave, and the amount that they want to go into each donation category. Let me show you how that is by doing an entry. I'll pick up another envelope here from Eliana McKenzie. So her donor number is 3. We enter that in the donor number column. My cell formula does a lookup and confirms the name. Then we do the amount. She gave $25 in cash. So you see we have a column here for the cash amount, for the check amount, or sometimes we get both in an envelope. It doesn't care whether you have one or the other or both. Then the next part is to enter the amount that she wanted to go into each donation category. Now you'll notice that her name is currently red. That's because these items are currently out of balance. It isn't until we fill everything in that it, oops, and that's the other reason we do that is a lot of times my fingers will slip and I'll hit the wrong amount. Right, or sometimes our donors write in the wrong amounts. So it forces me to make sure that this donation is in balance before I go on to the next one. And this simple little technique has saved us countless hours, because if you wait till the end, it's like finding a needle in the haystack. But fixing it while I'm on the donation makes it horrendously simple. Okay, now it turns out that Eliana actually wanted her donations to go not to the standard categories we have, but to one of our special offerings. And I know at our church it seems like we're doing special offerings all the time. So she wanted her $25 to actually go to our special offering for Vacation Bible School. So we put the amount in special, and the name is VBS for our special offering. Let me do one more. Let's do Dylan Snow. Now Dylan is donor number 101, but Dylan actually did his donation online, or maybe it's through Cash App or Venmo, Zelle, one of those kinds of things. So we put his amount, his $100 amount, in the EFT, Electronic Fund Transfer, column, because that money is already in the bank. Now we have a column here where you can put in a check number if you're doing checks, or for the EFT, you might want to put in like the type of EFT. Let's say it was a Cash App is the methodology he used for that donation. Now this is optional, you don't have to use it, but a lot of people like to identify the check number or the type of EFT. And then once we've done that, we need to distribute his $100, and Dylan said he wanted 25 in each category. Oops, sorry. 25 in each category. And the red goes away, showing that it's in balance. Okay, so it's just that simple to enter the record the donation information. So whether you're doing 20 or 120, it's just that simple. Now the other thing the software does is it helps us out with the counting of the cash and the checks. making sure that everything is recorded correctly and in balance. So currently we have an energy thing, so it's red showing it's out of balance. So what we do is, rather than trying to do the math in our heads and count the cash amounts, we're saying, no, just count the quantities. How many nickels, how many dimes? Let Excel do the math for us. So in our case, we have three ones, we have three fives, we have two tens, and two twenties. So we count the quantities, we enter it, and we see that everything now is in balance because the red went away for the cash. Same idea on the checks. We just enter the check amounts and let Excel total together, make sure we're in balance. So we had two checks this time for 100 and another one for 50. We enter those two amounts and we see that our checks are in balance. All right, one more thing that we do is to print this information. And if you think about it, this is exactly what we need for our bank deposit. So we print that and use that information for our bank deposit. The other thing was, we print this information down here, and these totals by category, that's what we give to our treasurer, who enters these amounts over into his QuickBooks system. Now, you don't have to know how to print in Excel or how to do these summaries, because I've done all of that for you. You don't have to know how to save the Excel file, because I have created a custom menu and it does all of the work for you. So once we're done doing our entries, We enter the cash amounts, the check amounts, make sure everything's in balance. Now we just simply come here to the custom menu and use option number 1. It will do all of the work necessary to save a copy, print the information, record the information as for our other reports. It does all that work for us. We just do custom menu, option number 1, hit the OK, and it's just that simple. Now, we have some other things we do at our church. Once a month, once we've done our last donation for the month, we actually have a report in here that we create, and it just prints our monthly amounts, each of our categories, the total amounts for each month, and the total so far in the year. So we print this once a month for our board our governing board. Now again, you don't need to know how to print this. You don't need how to total this. I have the cell formulas to do all of that work for you. You just need to use my custom menu and use option number 5 to print this monthly report. The other thing we've done is to print our annual receipts for each one of our donors that donated in the year. And so we have a receipt already created in the software. My cell formulas are already in there to do the summarization that it needs to by person, by category. But you don't need to know anything other than to use my custom menu, option number 6. And that will print a receipt for every one of our donors that donated in that year. This used to take us hours to create these receipts. Now it's done in a matter of minutes. And behind the scenes, all the software, all the menu item is doing is just looking at our donor number, our donor list, whatever the first number is, it just drops that in here. The cell formulas update the information for that donor. We do an Excel print, and then it goes on and does the next one and the next one. But again, use my custom menu to do that work for you. You don't have to do any of this. It'll do all of that for you and print your receipts in just a matter of minutes. All right, let's take a look at what do you need to do if I send a copy of this to you and you want to use it for your church. Well, the first thing is you need to come here to the parameters tab. I've created a list of parameters here that you would use to customize this for your church. So simple things like church name and address, the treasurer's name, right? So just fill in these simple parameters. We have one more down here that's really important. Because each church uses a different name of, or a different number of categories that they record, as well as different names. So you want to enter the number of categories that you want to use for your church, up to 20, and define the names that you use for your donation categories. Then the other thing, if you are not in the United States, you'll want to customize this information down here for the currency information, the currency and the values for each of your coins and bills. But again, only needed if you're not in the United States. Okay, once you've done that, the other thing you'll need to do is to customize the list of donors, your donor list. Now, a lot of churches I work with are already using the envelope system, so they have envelope numbers assigned to people. Other churches would use like a member ID. If you don't do any of that, not a problem. Just create a simple list, 1 to 100, and fill in your donor names. Once you have your parameters set up to customize it for your church and your donor list, then the last thing you do is just a simple Excel save to save that setup information. From that point on, you are ready to start using this for your donations. Okay, just to finalize everything here, the last thing I want to talk about, what if you are a non-English speaking church in the United States, or perhaps you're in a different country? You'll want to customize the language as well. So we have a translation tab here, and what we're doing is just simply entering in your language these English words. You're just translating that to your language. Now, to be honest, what you probably want to do is just take all of these words over to something like Google Translate, bring the whole collection back and paste it in here, and then start reading. That'll get you probably 95% of the way there, and then just read down through these words and make sure Google did a good job of translating it. If not, just customize the yellow cells and fix it up in your language. And let me just show you what that would look like. I'm going to open up a sample church from the Dominican Republic. I'll drag that over here. And what you'll see is that the entry information is all in Spanish. When you get down here to the bottom, this is in then the Dominican currency. If we look at our reports, it's all in Spanish. If we look at our receipts, it's in Spanish. The parameters are in Spanish. Okay, so everything has been translated. In fact, even the menu, my custom menu, is in Spanish as well. So that's what I wanted to show you. If you're interested in a copy, look at the description, the video description. You'll see my email address in there. Just send me an email address and request a copy. I'll be happy to send it to you. I also have a link in the video description of a more in-depth demonstration if you want to see that. All right, again, my name is Doug Leisure. Send me an email if you want a copy of this for your church. All right, thank you.